everyone, let us start our today's session. So in our today's session, I will discuss about few terms about the unit, fundamental quantities and the derived units, okay? And after that, we will solve some numerical problems also, which I have written for you. So what is the unit? You see here, a unit may be defined as the standard of reference chosen to measure or express any quantity. The way to express any quantity in a standard form, किसी भी quantity को standard form में represent करने का तरीका, okay? That is to be known as unit, okay? Now, next is fundamental quantities are what? All physical quantities may be expressed in terms of selected basic quantities called fundamental quantities, okay? So here you have to understand, all the physical quantities which are to be expressed in terms of selected basic quantities, okay? So this is to be of fundamental quantities, okay? Now the next, we are coming for the derived unit. Any unit obtained by multiplying or dividing one fundamental unit by another fundamental unit. Fundamental units ko, like suppose you are having some fundamental units, and the unit which we are finding by dividing or multiplying any fundamental unit is to be known as derived unit, okay? Or derived from the basic unit, means we are getting that unit from the basic unit, so that is to be known as derived unit. Let us see here. So like example, mass, this is for amount of matter present in it. So mass, it is to be represented in the form of kg or the gram. So 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram. As we talk about the weight, force exerted by the gravity on an object, we know that this is to be weight. Okay, so W is equal to what is to be m into g. And suppose we are talking about density. So density, like suppose I am giving the examples for derived unit. So we are getting density. Density, this is to be mass upon volume. So mass is the main basic unit. Volume is also basic unit. So from this mass is to be divided by volume, we are getting this density. So density, that becomes the derived unit. And its unit, that is to be mass, it is to be of kg, volume, that is in meter cube. So that we can write kg per meter cube, or we can write gram per centimeter cube. Okay, now next, it is to be of velocity. If we talk about velocity, this is to be of distance upon time. This you know that. So that distance and time are the basic unit, and from these two basic units we are getting the unit for velocity, meter per second. This is for the derived unit. Okay, in the same way, as we can talk about the acceleration, this is to be of speed upon time. Speed and time are the basic unit, and unit, derived unit, we are getting meter per second square. Okay, so here fundamental units, these are, I have written for you, you can see, standard reference chosen to measure the physical quantity. All the physical quantity, the properties of the substance which can be measured by using some apparatus. Okay, so like standard reference which we use to measure the physical quantity, this is to be known as unit. Okay, so the seven basic fundamental units are here, that I'm just telling: length, mass, time, electric current, temperature, amount of substance, and luminous intensity. Okay, so length, it is to be denoted by L, mass m, time t, small t, not the capital T, because capital T, it is to be of temperature. Electric current I, temperature capital T, amount of substance n, luminous intensity IV. Okay, and these are symbols M, kg, S, A, K, mole, and CD. These are for the candela, their unit, SI units: length, meter, kilogram, second, current for ampere, temperature Kelvin, amount of substance in mole, and luminous intensity, that is to be in the term of candela.